Hi, my name is Matt Fellows. Today I'll help you better your understanding of the poem The 23rd Psalm, and I will tell you why this piece is so special to me. First off, I'll read and analyze the poem. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, and thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me on all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Start off with the first line. It states, "The Lord is my shepherd." According to the Jewish Virtual Library, King David, who wrote the psalm, was a shepherd himself and liked to refer to the Lord as one too. A shepherd's sole purpose is to care for his flock of sheep, as they are slow and defenseless against predators. It is to take them to the best field possible for grazing and keeps them together. One may relate this to how God will do this for us if we follow him and respect his will. The Lord also acts as a shepherd in many ways, guiding us in the wrong or the right direction. He also gently prods us if we step in the wrong direction. He can keep us on the right path, just as a shepherd would do for his flock. "I shall not want" is a very powerful statement. According to Dr. Lawrence Wilson, his interpretation is that he may have everything he will ever need if he allows God to be a shepherd. This is one of the most meaningful parts of the poem, as it provides a sense of comfort. If one does not want, one will already have everything he or she needs. "He maketh me lie down in green pastures." This deepens the feeling of comfort, as God will make sure everything is all right. The use of "maketh" can be interpreted as God making us lie down, as sometimes our bodies need sleep and we are forced to rest. "He leadeth me beside the clear waters." Still connected with the last line, the clear waters represent happiness and cleanliness. "He restoreth my soul." This line shows the healing powers of the Lord. A person who experiences physical defeat due to trauma or sickness may also feel as if he or she has lost his or her soul. God has the power to restore this if a person simply talks to him. "He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake." God will lead the lost in spirit, and how someone who feels down about themselves will still be guided in the right direction. "Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me." This is also a very important line in the poem. One may need to deal with something difficult in his or her life, but the Lord is always with you. Trusting God and knowing that he will protect you will give anybody the courage to tackle any obstacle, no matter how difficult it is. "Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over." These three lines provide even more comfort and courage. The rod and the staff are used to keep us on the right path as a shepherd guides his flock. "A table before me in the presence of mine enemies" shows that God will not only protect us, but will take care of us in the presence of our worries with a fully prepared table. Anointing someone on the head with oil back in the day was like being awarded or dignified for something, as one is awarded for not wanting, as said on line one. The cup running over represents how we have more than we need. "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." These two lines provide a happy ending to the poem, as life ends happily if one follows God and is granted access to the paradise of heaven. This poem is very special to me. First off, I'm a devout Catholic, and I believe strongly that the presence of God is the most important thing in my life. Second, I've experienced things last September that I want to wish upon my worst enemies. I've had times in my life where I've had no idea where to go, and without the help of God and my friends and family, I wouldn't be anywhere close to where I am today. Thank you.